Hi, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. As Jake mentioned, my name is Sam or Samantha. I am a recruitment officer here at Ryerson, a very proud graduate from Ryerson's journalism program. And today I'm here to deliver your What's Next presentation as part of Ryerson's virtual open house. So let's talk about what's next in terms of what to expect with today's presentation. So we're going to be starting by discussing Ryerson in the news. I'm going to be sharing some news clippings from each of our six faculties just to give you an idea of some of the exciting things that are going on before I talk about what's next. So we're going to be talking about what's next in terms of those of you who are still waiting to hear back on an offer before we talk about what's next for those of you who might have already heard back from us and what those steps look like. We'll be talking about admission decisions and timelines, what to do when you're in, which is really exciting, and what your next steps are. Further developing your Ryerson community, as well as how you can continue to stay connected with us throughout this cycle. But as I mentioned, I do want to start with our Ryerson in the News segment, because although we're physically not on Ryerson's campus, there's so many new and exciting things going on across our institution. We'll start with the Faculty of Arts, where we recently announced some brand new co-op options. We specifically launched some new co-op options within our English program, our history program, our politics and governance program, and the sociology program. We are continuing to look at rolling out and expanding co-op options within the Faculty of Arts, but this is our first year offering co-op within these specific programs, and we're really excited about it. These programs join every single program in the Faculty of Science, the Faculty of Engineering and Architectural Science, and the Ted Rogers School of Management as having co-op opportunities for our students if there's something that students want to take advantage of. Even if you've applied to a program in our Faculty of Arts or you're interested in a Faculty of Arts program and it doesn't have a co-op yet, there are so many different hands-on opportunities where you're just going to your class and getting to do whatever it is that you're studying, whether it's an internship opportunity, whether it's a field trip or a lab component. All the programs in the Faculty of Arts have that, but these are our brand new co-op options. We've also recently announced some new double majors within our Faculty of Arts. Previously, you could do a double major in English and History, History and philosophy in English, but we have expanded the repertoire to what's listed on this slide here. And the best part, in my opinion, about this is you don't have to decide if you want to do a double major right off the bat. You'll make your application to Ryerson on one program that you know for sure you would like to major in or you think you'd like to major in. And once you join us at Ryerson, you'll start to take some courses from these different disciplines. And if you decide to pursue a double major, the faculty and staff who are really amazing will help you with that process. Over in our Faculty of Community Services, we're so excited to see our nursing students playing key roles in delivering COVID-19 vaccinations. So in our very popular nursing program, we do have a unique collaboration with Humber River Hospital, and that has ultimately resulted in fourth year nursing students filling key roles in staffing COVID-19 vaccination sites, as well as testing sites across Toronto. Now, the nursing program support at Humber River allows the hospital to facilitate the clinic without affecting patient care or staffing in other areas of the hospital. And it truly gives our nursing students an unparalleled access at a real world and real life opportunity to actually get to do what it is that they're studying while giving back to our community. In the Faculty of Communication and Design, we had Tommy Hilfiger announce that their People's Place program had selected Ryerson's Fashion and Race Database as one of its first round of partners, which is outstanding. The partnership specifically focuses on funding and supporting research through a study called the Unsung History of American Sportswear. And that specifically looks at influences from Black American culture on Tommy Hilfiger fashion. The Fashion and Race Database was founded by a Ryerson Fashion Associate Professor, Kimberly Jenkins, who's pictured right here. And it's something you can get involved in as a fashion student at Ryerson. In our Faculty of Science, we have a recent award winner. Chemistry professor Stefania Impellizzeri has received the 2021 Emerging Investigator Lectureship Award from the Royal Society of Chemistry. And this award specifically recognizes folks within chemistry that are creatively making outstanding contributions to their field at an early age. So we're quite happy to have Stefania. Stefania helms the Impellizzeri lab here at Ryerson. And in that lab, they conduct research pushing the boundaries of physical, organic, and materials chemistry. And again, one of the many different labs you can take part in as a chemistry student at Ryerson. Had some amazing success in our Department of Architectural Sciences. So we've had some undergraduate students recently win an award as part of a case competition. They actually redesigned an existing traffic corridor in Las Vegas. And by doing that, they actually won first place in the student category at the Institute of Transportation Engineers Micromobility Sandbox Design Challenge. And in our Faculty of Engineering and Architectural Science, one of our engineering graduates startups has been in the news quite a lot recently. So this picture here is Adrian. And while Adrian was at Ryerson, he started a company through our IBU zone, which is one of the 10 different zone startups we have here at Ryerson. His company is called Quantavice. And within his company, he's designed smart socks and smart gloves that hook up to your smartphone and keep your hands warm at the touch of a button. Now, while Adrian was at Ryerson, he actually won 2 Norman Esch Engineering Awards. And those are engineering awards that students can apply for funding for entrepreneurship projects that they're working on. So he won one for $8,000 as well as one for $25,000. And his company has only continued to grow since he's left Ryerson. And lastly, over in the Ted Rogers School of Management, you might be familiar with DECA. Maybe you have a DECA club at your school. Ryerson DECA does pretty well, which is great. They actually recently won the Chapter of the Year Award, which is the award that's given to the Canadian university with the most engaged delegates. And specifically reps from DECA, they also won first place overall in the Project Management Challenge and the Marketing Challenge, as well as second overall in Accounting and in the Fashion and Retail Management Challenge. So hopefully that's kind of gotten you excited about joining us at Ryerson and giving you an idea of what the possibilities could look like. They truly are endless at Ryerson, which is one of my favorite parts about having gone to Ryerson and working here. But hopefully that got you excited. Let's now talk about the next steps to get you ultimately as a Ryerson student. So I'm going to start with the next steps for those of you who are waiting on a decision from us before transitioning over to talk about what your next steps look like if you do receive a conditional offer from us. So let's start with best practices for maintaining your Choose Ryerson portal page. This is probably something that's familiar to most of you if you've applied. If not, if you haven't applied quite yet or you haven't applied to us just yet, you will be familiar with this. Once you apply, activate your online identity and upload any required transcripts, non-academic requirements, the supplementary form. You will see all that in your Choose Ryerson portal page. And you should be able to see the application status for each and every program that you've applied to here at Ryerson. So applications for the program under review will be listed on this page until an admissions decision has been made, or if you decide to cancel your offer or cancel your application to Ryerson. This status will be updated once a decision has been made on your application. So we'll be sending you a communication when this happens, but it is really important that you regularly maintain and check into your Choose Ryerson portal page. Really important thing for you to note is we do not send decisions by the mail. So you definitely want to pay attention to your Choose Ryerson portal page because this is where you're going to hear whether you are receiving an offer from us at Ryerson. Really helpful tip in order to make sure you are in the know is if you add noreply@ryerson.ca to your email contact list, anytime you receive a communication in your Choose Ryerson portal page, you will receive an email to your personal email that you use to register on the OUAC, flagging it and letting you know that there is a communication waiting for you in your Choose Ryerson portal page. These communications have a notorious habit of going into your junk folder and we don't want that. So it might be great if you added noreply@ryerson.ca to your email contact list just to avoid that, or regularly stay on top of checking in with your Choose Ryerson portal page to see the updates as they happen. Now, if you're unsure if you're required to submit English language requirements as part of your application, all you have to do is check your Choose Ryerson portal page for that blue bar entitled English Proficiency Results, and that'll let you know, and it'll let you know the status on whether we are waiting for those results or if we have received those results. It is in your best interest to complete your EP results and have the test submitted as soon as possible, but the deadline to provide a test score to us is on March 1st, 2021. Great idea to also let us know when to expect that test so we know to look out for it. And you can do so by clicking the RAMS tab as part of your Choose Ryerson portal page or my.ryerson.ca and letting us know then when we should be expecting a test result from you. Now, if you're unsure if you're going to be meeting those English language requirements and you are academically qualified for one of our undergraduate programs, we do have some really amazing pathway options that might be a great fit for you. One of them is really new and we're excited to launch it. It is our English Boost program, which is an 8-week intensive summer program that allows you to start your undergraduate program in the fall. There's also the ESL Foundation program, which has multiple entry points. So one of them is in the fall, One of them is in the winter and one of them is in the spring, and that will help you develop your reading or writing skills. The length of the program is determined by what your English language test results are. That dictates that length. And once you complete that program, you will be able to transition straight into your undergraduate program. Same with your English Boost. Once you finish that 8-week intensive, you will start right in the fall that undergraduate program of your choosing. So maybe you just came from us from my colleague Franco's presentation and you discovered a brand new program that you're really excited about. Or maybe you just want to add another application as perhaps a backup when you're looking at applying to us at Ryerson. We do have a list of programs that are still accepting applications, which is listed here, but all you have to do is Google Ryerson program still accepting applications or take a screenshot of this slide and check that out. This site is regularly updated to give you an idea of which programs are still open to accepting applications for the fall 2021 intake. You're more than welcome to apply to any program that is still accepting applications, but do note that programs are subject to close at any given time because we are past the guaranteed date to apply to us at Ryerson for the guaranteed consideration date. Now we know timelines are a very big question for applicants at this time of year, and I'm sure many of you might be wondering when you're going to hear back if you haven't heard back yet. So I know Jake already talked about this, but I'm going to say it again. Admission decisions at Ryerson, they are released on an ongoing, continuous, rolling basis. So every day we're reviewing applications or we're making decisions or we're re-reviewing. So we're continuously rolling out offers to our qualified applicants. We have been releasing some decisions over the past little bit, so some of you may have heard back from us already, but do note the majority of our decisions are made between February and June. So if you haven't heard back just yet, there's still plenty of time to hear back from us. Students that apply by February 1st will be notified by late May if they are accepted, denied, or on the waitlist. And if you are given a waitlist spot, you will be notified of any movement off of that waitlist. The admissions committee does a really great job at making sure students are notified when they're moved off that waitlist. For those of you that have applied to a Grades Plus program, there's a lot that goes into reviewing those applications. We know you did so much hard work with your non-academic requirements. That took a lot of time, and we want to give that a lot of time as well when it comes to reviewing that and making sure that we're understanding who you are as an applicant. So typically it does take us a little bit longer to start rolling out offers of acceptance to our Grades Plus programs. To see the earliest offer dates for these programs, all you have to do is go to the website. Again, that's listed right here. Or again, Google Ryerson admission timelines and it'll show up. And it'll give you an idea of when the earliest you might hear back for some of our Grades Plus programs to hopefully help ease your mind a little bit as you go through the waiting period. So to summarize the points that I just made as you wait to hear back from us, really important that you stay on top of your Choose Ryerson portal page, as again, this will be where you hear back from us regarding a decision on your application. Make sure you are submitting your English language requirements if they're required. And a great idea would be to start looking at some of the pathway options if you think that you won't be able to achieve those English language requirements, if you think you're just a little bit shy of that. And I didn't talk about this yet, but a great thing you can do while you are waiting is to join us at one of our different Ryerson at Home sessions. So if you visit ryerson.ca/at-home, you can see the countless different webinars, Reddit AMAs, office hours, just all the different things that you can go to, such as the virtual open house, to help you decide if we are the best fit for you, because that is the most important thing when it comes to making your decision. All the universities are so amazing. It's just about finding the best fit. And hopefully we are the best fit for you. We do a presentation every Monday called Ryerson 101. So similar to this, but it's a different theme every week based off what is going on with the admission cycle. You can book a meeting with a student recruiter or one of our current students. Our international team of recruiters, they're awesome. They're super fun to talk to and you can book an appointment with them as well as I mentioned, some of our students. We also will be holding some exciting applicant receptions in April. So stay tuned to your inbox for those details. So for those of you who might have heard back, let me be one of the first to welcome you to the Ryerson family, or the Ramily, as we like to call it, because we are the Ryerson Rams and you are part of the Ryerson family. It is definitely a little bit cheesy, but we absolutely love it. So let's talk about what your next steps are as a potential future Ryerson Ram. There are three steps to go through once you are an accepted student. The first is to respond to your offer by the confirmation deadline date specified in your offer of admission. The second, meet the conditions outlined in your offer of admission. And the third, make your deposit by the tuition fee deadline date. I'm going to go through all these steps to make sure you feel like you are ready to make these next steps. So let's start with accepting your offer and how that pertains to the Choose Ryerson portal page. So when the university has given you an offer, you will be able to find it in your OUAC account, which is what you should have used to apply to us. Look at the admission decision column on the OUAC. You'll be able to click accept, click I'm ready to submit my offer, or submit my response, sorry, and verify and agree. And that ultimately, all those different steps will confirm to us that yes, you're interested in joining us as a future Ryerson Ram as part of the Ryerson family. You will also receive a notification to your personal email, once again, as well as to your My Communications section of your Choose Ryerson portal page, which will be where you find that conditional offer letter of acceptance. So I just mentioned it, a conditional offer of acceptance. Your conditional offer of acceptance means that you must meet the conditions which are outlined in that offer letter in order to be a fully accepted and fully fledged Ryerson student and to make that transition to us in the fall. There are two things that you should note about the conditions in your condition letter. Admission averages. So in your condition letter, you're going to be given some admission averages that you have to maintain in terms of your overall average, as well as the required admission averages in terms of the prerequisite courses to get into your program. Now, these admission averages are based on up to 2 decimal places and they're not rounded up. So that means that you really do need to make sure that you are meeting those averages that are outlined in your conditional offer letter because we don't round up. So make sure that you're doing that. You are also ultimately responsible for ensuring that undergraduate admissions receives your final official results by the deadline date that will be listed in your offer letter for us to clear those conditions. So how do you do that? Let's discuss that next. So you might have noticed an area on your Choose Ryerson portal page where your official transcript is listed, and you might have noticed it says upload not available. Now that's because uploaded transcripts to the Choose Ryerson portal page are not considered official to us. So we require an official copy, either being mailed into us or through the OUAC, depending on which type of applicant you are. And by doing that, it'll ultimately clear the conditions of your offer because we will have those final grades that dictate that you've done as such. When we've received this final official copy, you'll be able to see it in your Choose Ryerson portal page as received, and that'll give you a little bit of peace of mind to know that we officially have it, it's been sent. So for our OUAC 101 and a select number of OUAC 105 applicants, your final grades that you have obtained through your Ontario Secondary School diploma, or for some select out of province applicants, whatever diploma you are seeking, those grades will be sent to Ryerson by your guidance counselor via the OUAC. Now, as I just mentioned, specific out-of-province applicants do have their grades submitted to us by the OUAC. So some of you in British Columbia, for example, get your grades sent to us through the OUAC. But as an Ontario applicant, that is done by your guidance community. That's why it's really important that you make sure your guidance counselor and your guidance office knows about enrollment in all of your courses, including anything that's being taken out of your regular high school or regular day school courses. So any night school courses that you're taking, maybe it's a private school course that's outside of your regular schooling, perhaps you took a summer school course in the past, just check in with your guidance office and make sure that they have all of that information because they are the ones that send that information to the OUAC, who in turn send it to us. And we just want to make sure that we get everything that you're doing. You can actually review your courses and grades that are provided by your guidance counselor in the current high school information and grades section on your OUAC application. So could be something that you should look into as well. Now for our OUAC 105 applicants, you are actually responsible for submitting your official academic transcripts to us, confirming your final grades as well as your graduation status. You did it. You should be shouting that from the rooftops. We want to know that you did it. So that's why you have to send us your final transcript. You can do so by actually physically mailing us a sealed official copy of your final transcripts to undergraduate admissions at Ryerson. Same deal with our OUAC 101 students. You are able to confirm that we have received that final official transcript through your Choose Ryerson portal page. Once we get that transcript and we put it into our system, you will see that status change to received on your Choose Ryerson portal page. If you feel like it's been a while since you've sent it and you haven't seen that status update, please do feel free to check in with us. You can do so by checking in with the amazing folks who work with us at our service hub, ryerson.ca/service hub. You can see all the different ways you can connect with them. And we can just check in and see what the status is and what's going on with that. You can also see the formal address, which you need to send the transcript to on the service hub website under the contact us section. Want to talk about some more frequently asked questions that we're receiving to hopefully give you a little bit of peace of mind in terms of offers of acceptance. So say you've been given a decision, but you're holding out to hear from another program. What should you do? If you've been given a decision, but you're holding out and you think you would be happy in the program that you've been given a decision to, even if it's not your top choice, we still really do encourage you to accept that offer. Acceptances, they do have expiration dates, so you do have to make sure that you're staying on top of that. And we will still continue to evaluate any applications to whichever program or programs you're still waiting to hear from us, even when you've already said yes to another program. Another question we get a lot is, does accepting an offer hurt my chances at being accepted to another program? Happy to say no, it does not. Accepting your offer from one program or another university, it does not cancel pending applications to other programs or universities. However, you can only say yes to one program at a time. So keep that in mind, you can't say yes to a bunch of different programs at once. Say you say yes to a program and then you receive an offer for a different program that you are more inclined to say yes to. You would have to decline that first yes in order to say yes to your new yes. So you can only say yes to one program at a time before you can accept a new program offer. And then that third step, how to pay your tuition deposit. So you'll see in your offer letter that you will be required to make a tuition deposit to secure your spot. Now, tuition deposits don't start until May 15th, so you've got a little bit of time to start planning your finances and putting that together. And again, if you have already received an offer from us, you don't have to start paying that until May 15th. In fact, we encourage you not to pay that until May 15th because that is when it starts. The tuition deposit deadline is on June 8th, 2021, or whatever date is stipulated in your offer of acceptance, if it differs from that June 8th deadline. And the deposit amount for all full-time undergraduate programs is $600 Canadian. So how to pay your tuition deposit. If you applied to a program with non-academic requirements, this might be a familiar process for you. But if this is your first time putting money towards this at Ryerson University, happy to go through that with you. Essentially, to pay your tuition deposit, if you're using a Canadian bank, you're going to do so by adding us as a bill payment through either telephone banking or online banking. Or you can go into your local branch if it's currently open at this time in order to do so. Essentially, you add Ryerson as a payee under your bill payments. The official wording of it, it's Ryerson University tuition and res fees. So that's the correct one. And you'll be using your 9-digit student number as your account number when you are setting that up. And then you'll just be able to make bill payments when tuition is due, or again, towards your tuition deposit of $600. If you're an international student without a Canadian bank account, you will be paying through Western Union Business Solutions Global Pay for Students. And that's where you'll have the ability to either pay through your local bank or using a credit card and in the local currency from where you are joining us from. To confirm that Ryerson has received your tuition deposit, you'll be able to check that through your RAMS account. Again, that's at my.ryerson.ca. RAMS is going to be something you're going to be using quite a bit as a student when you join us. This will be where you're actually enrolling in your courses. This is where your student fees section is. So this is where you'll see your tuition deposits as well as tuition fees that are due. So essentially when you open this, if you go to your student fees section, you will be able to see a negative balance reflected when we've received that money from you. So if you see something like negative $600 here, that means we have received your tuition deposit. Your remaining tuition balance and fees for the fall 2021 semester will appear on your RAMS account in August, and your fees for fall of 2021 will be due in the first week of September, in September, with late fees beginning in October for any outstanding payments. We do semester by semester payments, so you won't be charged your winter fees until January. Speaking of payments, now is a great time to remind you all of the amazing scholarship and awards opportunities we do have here at Ryerson, because we want to reward you for all the hard work that we know that you're doing. In your Choose Ryerson portal page, you'll be getting a communication with notification whether you qualify for one of our guaranteed and renewable entrance scholarships for our Canadian applicants or our students coming straight out of a Canadian high school. We do also have, though, faculty-specific entrance scholarships, Indigenous scholarships, and many more application-based scholarships as well. All of our application-based scholarships are housed through our amazing awards portal called AwardSpring, which is like your one-stop shop for all of your scholarship applications. You should have access to start browsing that right now, but you won't necessarily have access to apply to all of those scholarships. That is something that comes as you progress through the application cycle and you get closer to these warmer months where we're giving you a lot of more new student resources, but it never hurts to start checking that out and to familiarize yourself with that platform. Just a reminder for our students coming straight out of a Canadian high school of these guaranteed and renewable entrance scholarships. So if you're joining us straight out of a Canadian high school with at least an 80% overall average, you will automatically be considered for one of our guaranteed and renewable entrance scholarships. No application needed. These awards are based off of your final grade 12 results, and we calculate that in a number of different ways depending on what province you are joining us from. Again, we really do know that you're doing so much hard work right now, and given the circumstances, we want to reward you for the hard work that you're doing. So that is where these scholarships come into play. And keep in mind that if you are able to maintain these averages while you are with us at Ryerson, that scholarship amount will be renewable. For those of you that self-identify as Indigenous, Inuit, or Métis, we do have a specific set of Indigenous scholarships that are available to you. You can see all the information on our Indigenous scholarships on the Ryerson Aboriginal Student Services website. You can also visit that to learn about some of the different offerings that we have for our Indigenous students, such as traditional Indigenous counseling with our elder, as well as some admissions advocacy information, and again, our scholarship opportunities. Now, for those of you, I know when Jake launched that poll, we had a couple of you identifying the fact that you were a college or university transfer. You really do make up an amazing part of our community here at Ryerson. So this information is great for you because you might want to start looking at applying for transfer credits. A reminder for our students looking to join us from college, the minimum for your grade for a transfer credit has to be 70% or a B minus and 60% or a C minus from university grades. Now to apply, you'll be using the self-service online form on your RAMS account, which is method number one. Transfer credit applications are processed after May 1st, to which you'll find an official transfer credit results report posted to your RAMS account. If you have any questions at all about the transfer credit experience or the journey with transfer credits and applying for them, as well as seeing equivalency tables, feel free to reach out to tcredits@ryerson.ca and those folks would be more than happy to help you through the process. And then for those of you who might be taking an AP, IB, or CEJA curriculum, we know, again, you're doing quite a bit of hard work as well, so we want to reward you for that, and we do so by offering you the potential for transfer credits. You can find and look at equivalency tables for your courses on the Ryerson Transfer Credit website. How that works for you is after accepting your offer of admission, you will be applying using the manual application upload process, which is method number two on the Transfer Credit website. You'll upload some detailed PDF outlines of your course syllabuses or syllabi. You'll also be identifying your high school or CEJEP institution as the institution when we're asking for that. And then you'll receive an acknowledgement email to your Ryerson account after May 1st, to which a verified report will be posted to your RAMS account. Please note that it can take up to 8 weeks to process these, so your patience is truly appreciated as we go through and try and award you for your transfer credit eligibility. So now that you are officially a Ryerson student, let's talk about your Ryerson community and how you can forge those relationships and further develop and make the Ryerson University community your home. One way to make the campus your home is to physically live on it. Now, not everyone chooses to live on residence, and that's totally okay. You'll find so many other different ways to form and build community here at Ryerson, but a lot of students do want to live in residence, and that is a great opportunity to build community. So, for you to know, applications to residence have opened. They are officially open. Any student that has a conditional or full offer of acceptance is able to begin the process of applying to residence. How that works is you're going to create an e-res portal on the Ryerson Housing website, and that's how you'll submit your application online. You'll be paying a non-refundable $50 fee in order to do so, and the deadline to apply to be considered in the first round of offers is on June 8, 2021. So it's equal consideration until that point, and then after that point, applicants that apply will be placed at the end of the priority list. So keep that in mind if you're able to try and get that application in before June 8, 2021. Great thing you can do before you put that application in is do your research, because we have three different residence buildings that are all right on the Ryerson campus right there. So it takes you like 2 minutes to walk from your residence space to class, which is really amazing. I loved that when I lived in residence. So it's really important that you do your research because the three buildings are quite different from each other. And again, you just want to find the building that's the best fit for you. So let's start with the building in the dead center of the slide. That is the DCC, the Daphne Coxwell Health Sciences Complex. Cool space because it's brand new. First eight floors are brand new facilities for students in our nursing program, our midwifery program, our nutrition and food program, and our public health and safety and occupational health and safety programs. So brand new facilities, we're so excited about that. And then on top of that is 18 floors of brand new residence space. So great if you're in one of those programs and if you live in that building, you never have to leave that building in terms of going to some of your core classes and going to your residence space. Now the building on the bottom right-hand corner, that is Pittman Hall, which is like your most classic style of residence that you see in the TV and the movies. It's apartment style, so you can have a roommate in your room with you, or you can have your own room. But either way, you're usually sharing a common kitchenette and a common bathroom with a couple other students. I should mention that residence is open right now, even with COVID-19, and the styling has changed. So students do get private rooms right now, and residence will keep you updated on what the status is in terms of what the housing assignments look like on the housing website. So keep that in mind, but traditionally, this is what our residence looks like. And then at the top right-hand corner of the slide is the building that I personally lived in when I went to Ryerson. That is the ILC, the International Living and Learning Center. Cool spot because it's like living in a hotel because it was a hotel before we bought it. So I loved it because I had my own room that I didn't share with anyone. I had my own bathroom I didn't share with anyone. I had a queen-size bed, which is bigger than the bed at my parents' house. So I loved it. It was great. And I met my best friends living on that floor and we moved into a house together after first year. So a residence treated me right. Another great way to make the campus your home is by getting involved in campus community life. So join a student group or a club. We have so many of them. We actually have over 80 different student groups. They are faith-based, they're food-based, they're culture-based. Some I always like to mention in my presentations include United Black Students at Ryerson, the Indigenous Students Association, there's the poker club where they get together and play poker in campus, in a lecture hall, virtually when we're not on campus. Esports has over 300 members. There's a K-pop group if you want to talk about BTS at the Grammys. All those opportunities are there for you. Best part is if we don't have a club and you want to start that club, there is ample opportunity to do that. Students actually come from over 80 countries and speak over 100 languages on Ryerson's campus. So you are bound to meet at least one other student who has similar interests as you and wants to start and join that club with you, which is really amazing. Another great way to get involved in campus life is through athletics and recreation. Maybe you love to work out, perhaps you're like me and you do not love to work out. There is still reasons for all of us to use the athletic centers that we have here at Ryerson. We're very fortunate because we have two and they're really easy to remember because they're called the RAC and the MAC. So the RAC is the Recreation and Athletic Center. It is three floors underground in the middle of our campus. So there is a 6-lane swimming pool, squash courts, gym equipment. You can play a pickup run with basketball. There's a track that you can actually run if you don't want to run outside, which is really great. You can also take courses in things like kickboxing, yoga, dance, number of different courses that you can take, and it's all included in your tuition fees. The RAC is also the home of our intramural athletics, that's the word I'm looking for. So if you're looking for a more relaxed style of sporting as opposed to varsity athletics, that is the place to go for that. We have everything from volleyball to badminton to inner tube water polo, which is water polo that's played on a floaty, and it's great because absolutely no one is good at it. Oops, forgot to mention the other athletic center we have, which is the Mattamy Athletic Center. Most people know this actually as Maple Leaf Gardens, and that's what's pictured right here in the slide. And it is where the Toronto Maple Leafs was founded and first played before they opened the Scotiabank Arena. So the building has some amazing history to it. Elvis, the Beatles, and the Rolling Stones, they've all played concerts in this building. Muhammad Ali has fought in this building. And so just a really amazing history that goes into the building. It has been completely renovated and it is all ours, and it is the home of our varsity athletics. So not only can you go here to work out with our state-of-the-art athletic facilities in terms of workout gear and equipment, you can also go here to take part in varsity athletics. So we do play at the U Sport level here, as well as through the OUA, Ontario University Athletics. So if you think you're at that caliber to compete, you can absolutely try out for one of our teams, or you can try being recruited on the Ryerson Rams website, ryersonrams.ca. You can just go to cheer on the home team as well, because that's a really fun thing to do. And our athletics are really good at Ryerson. How good, you might ask? Well, Lisa Haley, who is the coach of our women's hockey team, she's actually the assistant coach of the Sochi gold medal winning women's hockey team at the Olympics. Roy Rana, he used to be the coach of our men's basketball team. And I say used to be because he was actually poached by the Sacramento Kings NBA team. So he plays under Luke Walton, which is really exciting. you also never know who you're going to see at the athletic center. I had a job at the athletic center and I studied there because you see some really cool things. For example, we hosted the Invictus Games. So Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, they did make their relationship public on the Ryerson campus at the Invictus Games. The Raptors, they've practiced on our campus a number of times. I've watched the Leafs practice, which was really cool. LeBron James, you might know him as one of the best basketball players in the world, if not the best basketball player in the world. He was in town for Drake's music festival, OVO. He needed somewhere to work out. So he actually called up Ryerson to use our gym. So if it's good enough for LeBron, we hope it's good enough for you as well, but you can absolutely be the judge of that when you join us on the Ryerson campus. No matter what you're doing and involved in at Ryerson, we do want you to feel supported. And there are a number of different supports in place to, again, make you feel like this is your home and this is a place that you can thrive. We do actually have an entire building dedicated to student support. If you have been to downtown Toronto, you might have seen a really cool looking glass building across from the Toronto Eaton Centre. That is the SLC, the Sheldon and Tracy Levy Student Learning Centre. It has 8 floors of dedicated student workspace. The 8th floor is the one that's pictured on the right, and that's personally my favorite floor. It's called The Sky. We call it The Sky because it has an amazing view of the Toronto skyline. It's also a great place to nap between your classes because that sun beams on through and it's just a really relaxing spot. On the left-hand side of your screen, that is the 4th floor, which is called The Garden, and that's where you can go for accessibility accommodations as well as student learning support. So we can essentially put in any type of accessibility accommodation that you require in order to make your life a little bit better and smoother here at Ryerson. Students can register with Academic Accommodation Support Office once you've officially received your Ryerson email, and that typically happens about a month before the start of classes. What you can do in the meantime is use the interactive documentation tool that's on the AAS website to determine what you might need to provide in order to register with the Academic Accommodation Support Office. Now, you might be familiar with an IEP through your high school, and although IEPs can be a really great supplemental material when it comes to registering with AAS, it isn't the only thing that we require in terms of registering with the office. So that's why using that interactive tool can be really helpful, just so you can start to put in place what documentation we might need in order to make that registration. Now, as I already mentioned, we don't just have AAS, we do have Student Learning Life and Support, SLLS. You don't need any formal documentation to register with them. And those are the folks that offer things like group tutoring, math support, English support. Maybe you need help learning how to take notes a little bit better at university. We can absolutely help you do that. Maybe you need help learning how to write that first thesis paper. We would love to walk you through that process and help you out with that. We also have a great program called RU Tutor Match, which can actually match you up with an individual who can tutor you throughout the semester. So again, there's a number of different ways that we can help you thrive here at Ryerson through both academic accommodation support, as well as student life and learning support. Equity, diversity, inclusion, those are also some pillars of our institution. We are working continuously on providing these supports for our students. We've come a long way, but we know that there's tons of work that we still need to do every single day towards providing equity opportunities for our students. These are some of the initiatives that we currently have in place to, again, help our students make themselves feel supported here and to recognize the fact that you can have a home here at Ryerson. So some of these initiatives include Ryerson Pride or Rye Pride, the Good Food Center, which actually tackles food inequality amongst our student body, as well as the Trans Collective to make sure our trans students feel at home here at Ryerson. Another really great way to get involved is by joining Tri Mentoring at Ryerson. It's called Tri Mentoring because there are 3 different Tri Mentoring options. First one is something you might want to do right away when you start with us at Ryerson, which is peer mentoring. So when you are in your first year, you will be paired up with an upper year student from either your program or within your faculty or a student who has a very similar interest as you. And they act as your peer mentor and your buddy and make sure that you're really learning the ropes and feeling great as you join us here at Ryerson. So they can help give you some advice on what classes to take, what resources we have on campus. If there is a club that you might be a great fit for, they can really help out with that. And then it's a great thing for you to give back to when you become an upper year student. There's also career mentoring where students after third year have the opportunity to get paired with an industry professional to help them network and grow professionally. So again, they'll help you with your professional development, take you to some networking events, just really give you that additional career opportunity that we're consistently trying to help you build and establish a network here at Ryerson. And then the third part of tri-mentoring is the group mentoring for specific equity-deserving groups that we have here on campus and equity-deserving students we have here on campus, such as 2S LGBTQ+ students, our Black students, our Indigenous students, Filipinx students, women in STEM, students with disabilities, and many more equity-deserving groups. For those of you who are international, as part of Ryerson Student Life, we also have International Student Support, which is a division, as I just mentioned, of Student Life, and it's dedicated to fostering a sense of community and belonging for students that are new to Canada. One of the really great initiatives of International Student Support is getting our domestic students to meet our international students. We want you to build and forge those lifelong friendships, and we know it can be tough to sometimes build those friendships. So we do a lot of really fun social activities that anyone can get involved with. I know sometimes I like to go to their events and meet some of our international students, which is really fun. They also provide our students with immigration support, cultural and social support, as well as access to healthcare and helpful ways to get jobs on campus. Now, over the next couple of months, as we continue to progress through the admission cycle, there is going to be so much more information coming to your inbox, especially as newly accepted students, and if you decide to say yes to your offer. But I do want to highlight a couple of those different websites that might be good to start bookmarking and just putting that in place in the back of your mind as, again, we start progressing through the cycle. One of them is our new students website. So if you Google Ryerson New Students, or if you go to the after applying section on the Ryerson admissions website, you will see this website, which is amazing. It truly is kind of like a step-by-step process throughout the months of what your next step should be as a newly accepted student. So that's everything from when you should be applying for your student ID card, which is quite a ways down the line, when you're actually enrolling in courses, again, quite a ways down the line. But it's a great helpful step-by-step tool for you to realize when those things happen to make sure you're not missing anything. So again, that's the Ryerson New Students website. The Why Ryerson blog is also really great because it is helmed by our current students. I personally thought when I was making my applications, it was really great. Any opportunity I got to interact with current students to get that really authentic look at what life is like. Why Ryerson is an amazing blog to check out. They also highlight any upcoming deadlines and things like that, which is really helpful. There's also the Student Financial Assistance website, which is, again, something that you should start to be looking at in terms of planning your finances, OSAP, all that good stuff. Maybe you'll actually be joining us for our student financial assistance presentation as part of Ryerson's open house on Wednesday, March 17th. Bianca Maryshow, who is the assistant manager of student financial assistance here at Ryerson, she'll be leading that, and she is awesome. So stay tuned for that. A lot of helpful information will be there. There's the Ryerson Collaborative Nursing Approved Students website, and that has some amazing details about requirements for September, as well as the Engineering Approved Students website. A great resource as well for our engineering students is ryerson.ca/askeng, and you can actually book one-on-one appointments with our engineering admission officers, as well as see some of the first-year supports that will be in place for our engineering students. Now, a lot of the information on these websites has not been completely updated just yet, and again, that's because we're still early in the transition period, but I do want to highlight these things so you can bookmark them and stay tuned for when that information becomes available. And lastly, there's orientation and summer transitional support to look out to. We are progressing through that phase, so we don't have too much information to share with you right now, but do note that we have a robust selection of orientation and summer transitional programming coming soon. Really important that you stay tuned to your Ryerson inbox for all of this programming. It's helmed by our amazing student learning support team, and they do a lot of really fun stuff, social events, programming events, things in terms of transitional support like math, classes through D2L shells and things like that. So it's something to stay tuned to. Again, we don't have too many details to share just yet, but shortly that information will be coming. And we just really want to give you as many opportunities as possible to begin forging those relationships, building your Ryerson community out, and making your friends and family here at Ryerson. So stay tuned for more information. We'd also love it if you stayed connected with us, because we have a lot of information to give to you as we progress through the cycle. One thing you can do to stay connected is by joining the Accepted Ryerson Class of 2025 Facebook group, which you should actually be able to see on your Choose Ryerson portal page. If you click the New Students tab that's there, you'll be able to see a direct link to this Facebook portal page to, again, start forging those relationships and meeting some students from other programs. As I already mentioned, you can join us for so many different upcoming webinars, Reddit AMAs, Instagram Lives that we're hosting. We have another 2 weeks of open house going on, and all of this information is publicized on the Ryerson at Home website, ryerson.ca/@-home. That's where all that information is housed in one convenient spot for you. Now on that website, you'll see an opportunity to meet a Ryerson recruiter or a student ambassador. So if you'd like to book a one-on-one appointment where you get some one-on-one advising with a Canadian recruiter like myself or my fantastic team that I work with, an international recruiter, we have our amazing international team, so you can book a recruiter from your specific region that you are joining us from. Or we also have one-on-one bookings with our awesome student ambassador team, both international students as well as domestic students. There's no going wrong. We're all happy to give you information. So feel free to book an appointment with any of us. I can do so by clicking on the booking through the Ryerson at Home website. Although we can't take you on our campus right now, we would still love to show you campus, and you can check out our campus and see what your future home is going to look like by taking a virtual tour. And you can take a virtual tour, either a guided one where the little avatar pops up in the corner. You can see Franco, one of my colleagues, he actually gives that tour, and you can kind of go through it at your own pace. Or you're free to join us for one of our live tours where our student ambassadors actually share their screen, take you through the virtual campus tour, but they are actually the ones that are guiding you and they can answer your questions live on the spot, which is really great. We're actually hosting virtual campus tours as part of the open house, and those ones are faculty specific, so you might want to check that out, or again, feel free to join us at any one of our upcoming tours that we are hosting. I already mentioned the Service Hub. They cannot get enough praise. They do some amazing work, and they're a great resource if you have any questions about OSAP, admissions, or enrollment. They also have so many different ways to connect, whether it's through email, whether it's the live chat, whether it's ask.ryerson.ca, tons of different ways that you can interact and make sure that your questions are answered. And as I already mentioned, this is just day one of Open House. We have 2 full weeks of programming that's pretty robust, so you are more than welcome to register for any session that might speak to you. We would love to have you at any and all sessions. You might see my face a couple more times. So I do hope that you join us and continue interacting with us through these next 2 weeks as part of Ryerson's virtual open house. And finally, you can stay connected through social media. All of our handles are at YRyerson. We are very active on such social media handles as Instagram. That's my personal favorite one that we helm. We're also really active on TikTok. We do cool contests on TikTok. So if you're interested in winning some free swag, check us out on TikTok and participate in some of the events that we're hosting. So that's kind of it for me. I know I just gave you tons of information. Please do continue asking questions if you have any questions or if we can clarify anything that I spoke with or spoke about. Join us at our upcoming Ryerson 101 sessions where we can answer any questions you have. Book an appointment with me. I would love to talk to you one-on-one and give you any questions or advice or just share my experiences that I had here at Ryerson. Because again, at the end of the day, it truly is about finding the community that's going to be the best fit, finding the school that's going to be the best fit, and establishing and forging those bonds. And we hope it is with us at Ryerson as part of the Ryerson family, or again, the Ryerson family. So that's it for me. I'm going to be throwing it back to Jake, who will be closing us out with some final bits of information. So take it away, Jake.
Hey there, everyone. So first of all, thanks so much again to Sam for such a great session. So we are now going to shut down our audio and our video, but we'll still be online until the end of the hour to answer any questions that you may have. Feel free to submit those questions through the Q&A pod until the end of the hour. And I encourage you to make note of any answers to your questions before the session ends, because those won't be recorded. We do have lots of additional opportunities to connect with us, just like Sam was talking about. Check out that Ryerson at Home page to learn more about guided virtual campus tours, how to meet a Ryerson student, or to book a meeting with a recruitment officer, and more. Be sure to continue checking your Choose Ryerson portal for all updates, and check out our After Applying and Approved Students pages for your next steps. And should you have any questions, we are always here to help, and you can get in touch with our Service Hub through email, phone, social media, live chats, or by using ask.ryerson.ca. Lastly, at the end of this session, you will be directed to a survey. And if you do fill that out, we would really appreciate your valuable feedback. So on behalf of Ryerson University, thank you once again for joining us today. And we hope that yourself and your loved ones are happy, healthy, and safe. Take care, everyone.